here.
No.
Can he bless you all?
I'm not your grandpa. You, what's your name?
William.
Well, William, you're a sweet boy.
Sir.
You tell your mother I said you were a sweet boy.
Half of it.
Senior citizen.
Not without a card, you ain't.
Where's Charlie?
He's got the flu.
He knows me. Hello, Mrs. Franklin. You look just lovely today.
Hi there, Mr. Finnegan. That sure was a mighty pretty song you were playing.
Hello, brother. I like your hat. Did you buy it downtown someplace?
Didn't buy it, man. It's a present. From a lady. A nice, white lady.
That's the ticket. That's better than buying it. Nice white lady, huh? You like white ladies?
That's all I like.
There you go. You get yourself a pretty hat with feathers and a white woman. You think you got the world by the pistachios. Hello there, you pretty young thing. My, you do look just lovely today. Here's two fine-looking women. Now, what's one got that the other doesn't?
You too old to see the difference.
Well, you're not going to catch up with me, but you're not going to get any younger either.
I ain't worried.
Don't pay him no attention, Mr. Finnegan.
Excuse me.
What's your name, brother? You don't care to talk. Well, I enjoy bumping up against people. It's what I do these days instead of sex.
I had to move you. I need DeWitt up front by the editor's desk.
Well, I guess 25 years at the same spot is long enough.
I had DeWitt take all your stuff. I hope that wasn't presumptuous, Mike. Hey, he moved everything but this stuff.
What? Oh. I was wondering where the hell that was. I was supposed to wash it a week ago. Well, I don't suppose DeWitt will be needing this old chair.
Take the chair, Mike. You're back there. The letters to Felicity Hope are back there, too.
How many?
5, 6.
Felicity Hope used to average 45 a day before I took over.
So what? You have a more discriminating audience now. Someday she's the only thing on this paper that makes any sense. You've created a real crusty old broad there.
Yeah, I expect to be attending her funeral.
Nah, Jack wouldn't do that. He'll catch on. Mike, I haven't offended you by doing this.
Oh, forget it, Christian. The world moves on. You can put me anywhere you want to. Well, Finnegan, let's begin again. From the bottom.
Is a new peel. Look, you know, God, I hate this place.
This is my favorite place.
Your favorite place?
This is the only place I can see you.
I love seeing you.
So? It's my favorite place.
Why does it have to be here?
I can't afford anything else.
I'll pay for my
holiday. No, you will not pay for it.
I don't have to pilfer money out of Emily's household account. How is Emily?
Oh, Emily, you know, Emily goes along.
Goes along where?
She goes along to her junior league meetings, and she goes along to her little PTA stuff, but she just goes along.
In her little car.
I had a fantasy the other day about running over Emily with my car.
I've had that one, too.
But you know, that's no good. Okay.
Okay.
Listen, Mike. I gave you that advice column to get you out of the house. But in 3 months, you've almost blown Felicity Hope out of the water. We got 5 lousy letters today. 5, Mike.
I counted 6.
Mike, see, the tone is all wrong. You make them sound like they're selfish, pleasure-seeking idiots.
Exactly what they are. Everybody's screwing around and pretending it's the normal thing to do.
You understood the deal. The column stays hot or I get somebody else. You got 3 weeks, Mike. I'm sorry. You know I'm running a business here.
Okay, Chief.
Wait a minute. You got some kind of sign on your back.
Sign? What does it say?
This old mother for sale, Chief.
Well, you should have left it. I like it.
You're never gonna leave her, are you? Oh, my God.
Hello? Anyone in there? Anybody there?
It's a salesman or Jehovah's Witness.
Hello?
Maybe he can help.
Have you seen my...
On the doorknob.
Okay. I'm in the smell of you.
You could drop me off just this once. It's awfully hot out.
I could. Yeah. I could.
No, never mind. It's okay. Heat's good for me. Keeps me limber. Simply love the heat. Don't. You'll have to wash all over again.
A terrific dress.
It's new. This is driving me crazy.
The best we've got.
I know. You're my whole world. Once a week.
Can't be that. You gotta put me somewhere left of center. You gotta think of this as dessert. Fine, first-rate, expensive dessert.
Cherry's Jubilee.
Cherry's Jubilee. You all right?
I'm all right.
I better go.
I know.
Okay, good. You look wonderful. I love you. How can I leave you?
Thank you.
sweet thing. My, you look lovely today.
You seem to be troubled.
I'm fine.
Whenever I see troubled people, I can't help wanting to share the good news with them. My name is John Jewell.
That's the good news? I'm sorry, I'd just rather not talk.
Of course, I understand. But let me give you something that may be uplifting to you at a later time, something to read.
Thank you. I'll finish it later.
Please, it only takes a moment. I manufactured the thing myself. I can get it to you wholesale.
Yeah. You pull anything, mister, and I scream my head off.
I suppose I should be flattered. You think me capable of pulling something? What do you figure I am? Some kind of dirty old man?
It's a distinct possibility.
You have a dirty mind. Hello, darlings. You look lovely today. Just lovely. Your mother takes good care of you, doesn't she?
Hello, Mr. Finnegan.
Okay. You're harmless. I'm sorry. I'm just not myself today.
I saw you earlier, didn't I? You take this bus often?
Once a week. Usually later.
You've been crying. You want to talk about it?
Is this a city bus or a mobile psychiatric ward?
I'm sorry. Thanks for the offer, but I have laundry to do. Listen, have a lovely trip, wherever you're going. It was nice meeting you.
But we didn't meet. What's your name?
Liz. What's yours?
Mike.
We've met.
Hello again. I nearly forgot I had washing to do.
You following me?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I hate doing laundry alone.
Don't you have a wife?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes. What's that?
Some papers I have to break.
A school teacher. Yes, your speech is rather precise. Now, let me see. English.
I teach junior high art, among other things.
Well, I can see it in your outfit. Good eye for color. What other things?
I coach gymnastics.
Mm-hmm. Good muscles.
This year, I'm directing the school talent show. Any observations there?
Yes. You're a real glutton for punishment.
Yes. I like to stay busy.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth what?
Dahan. Michael who?
Finnegan.
I used to sing a song about Michael Finnegan.
I bet I'd redate it. Well, don't let me bother you. Do you know Auguste Dupin? Auguste Dupin. Ever heard of him?
Actually, no.
He's a Poe character. Edgar Allan. He's the detective in Murders in the Rue Morgue. He's more ingenious even than Sherlock Holmes. Well, Dupin solved his crimes through a process that Poe called ratiocination. It's a combination of deductive powers and creative imagination.
Really?
I mention it only because over the years, I also, in a limited way, mind you, have developed ratiocination. For example, I could probably recreate your present life situation with fair accuracy and with no hints from the audience.
I very much doubt that you could.
May I try?
Will you make it brief?
Well, in the first place, you're unmarried, at least right now. You live in an apartment.
That's amazing.
And you're having an affair with a married man.
You're not very funny.
No, no, wait a minute. I'm not done. You meet him once a week, Thursday afternoon. You take the bus so your car won't be noticed.
I don't have a car.
Whoops. Well, no one is as good as Dupin. Now, the man is married, probably with children. You want to marry him, but he won't leave them. Hence your obvious upset when I met you.
Who are you?
Oh, I'm no detective. I'm a newspaper man.
Oh, my God.
Listen, I'm not following you for Pete's sake.
Well, I am not amused by your speculations, and that's all they are, speculations.
The two of you had Chinese food, correct? You have a room someplace. He had to leave early today.
I'm going to be sick.
Obviously, I wasn't very far off. Now, how can I help?
I don't want your help. I find you utterly presumptuous. Please just leave.
I'm presumptuous as hell. I apologize. I'm really very sorry.
Waste you, I swear, man.
Oh, hell. Come on. I gave last month.
You shut your mouth, old white man. I ain't afraid to kill you.
Kid, let me give you some advice.
What are you doing?
You'll never make a criminal.
What are you doing?
For God's sake.
Your wallet. Give it to me.
Okay?
Give it to me.
All right. Here you go.
Give me the food. Give me the food!
So I'll have bread and milk tonight. I prefer it anyway. This morning I couldn't find the stove, and now it's the sink. Margaret! Damn it, I hear you. Margaret, I need you. Margaret, I need help.
Michael, what has happened?
Get a towel. I'll need to stop this bleeding.
Someone has hurt you.
No, some kid. He took our supper. He took the phony wallet, too. Well, that should make his day. It was full of religious tracts.
I should find that little gun. Michael, do you remember Father's little gun? Michael, have you seen it?
It's long gone, Margaret. We don't need guns.
I imagine you think I don't know why you're so late, do you? Michael, you mustn't take me for a fool.
Don't go away, Margaret. I was enjoying this.
You smell of something.
Margaret, I'm an old man. I don't mess around with anybody and nobody messes around with me. I've forgotten how.
Mentioned women. Where are you?
Downtown.
My neighbor took the kids to the game. They're out of my hair till 4.
You want to do something?
Well, sure. It's not Thursday, is it?
No. You want to meet me somewhere?
On the outside?
You mean of the room?
Yeah.
Paul, are you kidding?
How are you? Say, you want to join me?
You sound just like a man meeting his lover in an ice cream parlor.
I need practice.
Will we be safer at a table at the back?
I thought about that. But then I thought if somebody comes by and sees us, we look less suspicious if we're out in the open.
True, true. On the other hand, if we sat at the back and someone saw us, they'd assume we have nothing to hide because if we were lovers, we'd be too clever for the obvious out-of-the-way table.
Did I say something wrong?
No.
You look delicious.
You've never seen me in the daylight.
Laura.
Enjoy your dream, bud.
Sunday doesn't look bad either.
You're pretty busy today.
I have reason to be.
What kind of a kid do you suppose we'd have?
That.
A real sugar ball.
Mm-hmm. Cold feet, but warm heart.
I'd like to have a girl as gorgeous as you are.
Don't say things you don't mean.
I damn well mean it. The thought of spending a lifetime with Emily turns me to stone.
I'd love to believe that.
Hey, don't. Come on, who knows?
Dear Felicity, I have a husband who's killing me with boredom, exclamation point. We have 4 children who are real nice, comma, and one of them is in the Honor Society, period. But this man contributes nothing to our happiness except money, period. We have been married for 15 years, comma, and most of it is spent in front of the TV set, period. Some days I want to take an axe to the set and to him, period, paragraph. The problem is I've met another man, period. He is an angel, period. I felt dead until the day he came along, period. He is unmarried and younger than me, but he loves children, period. Is it too much for me to want my own happiness, question mark? I can't sleep at all, period. Please, comma, can you help? Question mark, yours truly, sleepless over love. Wow. Yeah. Dear Sleepless, You are suffering from an illness, period. You can see nothing clearly or whole, period. This quote angel, unquote, of yours is no more angel than I, period. And your husband is no devil, period. You imagine axing the old man, comma. You betray trust, comma. You endanger the well-being of your children, comma, and somehow you are able to translate it into a thing holy and good, period, paragraph. Get back into your own bed and face reality, period. Marriage is a contract, comma, a promise, period. It would be the same with someone else, dash, or worse, period. You are living a destructive fantasy, period. Transcend it and be whole again, period. Yours, comma, Felicity, hope. Idiots. Well, Felicity, old girl, at least we'll bury you properly.
That's it. Over there.
So you are a newspaper man.
Elizabeth Dunn.
What happened?
Is that my underwear?
Yes. I paid to dry it.
Well, I've given it up for lost.
Mr. Finnegan.
Mike.
Are you busy? Would you have lunch with me? There are a few things that I'd like to discuss with you.
How'd you find me?
I called your home.
Oh, boy. Come on.
Don't you want to look at the laundry?
Yes, I trust you.
You sure you don't want to look at it?
I'd rather look at you.
There isn't much open downtown on a Sunday.
This is fun.
There's a hotel a couple of blocks down.
No, really, it's fun. I'm just a little nervous.
I hope it doesn't spoil your appetite. The food isn't bad.
Won't. At a very fast metabolic rate. Hungry all the time. If I miss a meal, that's when I get sick.
I'm just the opposite. Never hungry these days. On the other hand, a beautiful woman could do wonders for my appetite. What are you nervous about?
You. How do you know so much about me?
I know nothing about you.
Please, I have to know where you got your information. There are people who could be deeply hurt by what you found out.
So that's it. Elizabeth, honestly, that was all educated guessing. I don't know who, what, why, where, or when. Believe me, there is nothing concrete I could tell the world about you.
I don't believe you.
You want a drink?
The man I love is a married man. He loves his children.
If he's so fond of his children, why is he screwing around?
You want some?
What do you drink?
A Bloody Mary.
We don't have no Bloody Marys.
Then a vodka gimlet.
We don't have them either.
What do you have?
Shots and beers.
Fine, I'll have one of those.
The same, Leo. Scotch.
He is not.
Who? What?
Screwing around. It's much more than that.
I've given you a difficult couple of days, haven't I?
What?
I'm sorry. Well, I owe you an explanation. Or rather, a recapitulation.
All right, how did you figure things out?
Single, simple. No ring.
My apartment?
No washing machine.
Married man.
More difficult, but not too. I'll lay money he's a guy in a dark blue station wagon. But the key, you were doing sheets. Just two sheets.
Yeah, well, there usually are two sheets.
Yeah, but nobody takes a bus cross town to a laundromat to do just two sheets. So, the two of you are in love, or so you think. But he has children, he can't make the break. What else could it be? I missed on the car.
I lied about the car.
Aha. Chinese food.
Mm.
The bag the sheets were in came from the Golden Dragon. And you were eating an egg roll on the bus.
Thank you.
To May from September. Amazing.
Are people
people always so transparent to you?
Your situation is simply very commonplace.
Yeah, well, maybe for the world it's commonplace. For me, it's not. You speak with such divine assurance.
Why not? I'm Felicity Hope.
You?
In the flesh.
You? I knew it! I knew a man was writing that column. No woman would ever be so jaundiced about love. Oh, this is really funny. You obviously don't enjoy it.
Good shot.
You are so damn contemptuous of your readers. There's no compassion in that column, just large doses of brutal reality. You usually write, of course, but I hate every word.
So do I.
Then why do you do it?
Well, it's either Felicity Hope or Shuffleboard at Sun City. They retired me from the city desk 3 months ago.
You are 65?
I don't understand it myself. Ouch.
Well, looks like you buy lunch, kid. You gonna eat your pickle?
No.
Thanks. I don't mean for the pickle.
Keep change, Leo.
Hey, wait a minute. Where are you going?
I teach today.
On Sunday?
Volunteer work.
When do you relax?
Thursday afternoons.
You mind if I tag along?
Suit yourself. You know, it's funny, but I never talked to a soul about Paul. I never dared trust it to anybody.
How long have you two been meeting?
Year and a half.
Without getting caught, he must be Houdini. 4 months was all it took Margaret to nail me.
Ha! And you're raising an eyebrow at my affair?
Nah, that was 25 years ago.
Did he ever forgive you?
Yeah, hundreds of times. This thing is going to drain you. I've been there. Believe me, I know all about it.
You knew about it when? During the Punic Wars? Things have changed.
Well, maybe. But let me tell you what I did when I was your age and mired in romantic love.
Mired is hardly the word I'd use.
Chin deep in it. I was obsessed with the woman every waking hour. I used to make up lists of things I was going to say to her, and then I'd prepare beforehand how I was going to say them. I actually found myself whistling corny songs on the street. I couldn't eat.
Couldn't eat? That's not my problem.
Or sleep. I neglected my wife, my son, my job. I was a selfish bastard and an emotional mess. That's romantic love.
Well, Michael Finnegan, you may have had a love affair once, but you've certainly forgotten everything essential about it.
Hey, I know that place. Elias Williams is a friend of mine.
Hey, come see you in there.
Does Elizabeth Ann work here?
You know Liz?
Yeah.
Well, she's got some of the fellas out in the class right now. You want to see her?
No. Don't bother her. What are you doing? Show me.
Oh, nothing much. You know, I was hoping I'd run into you somewhere along the line.
Yeah, I know why.
I'd like you to move out to some nice little place in the suburbs and sell me your house.
Don't talk to me. Margaret's the one.
We're busting out at the seams here. I figure no one want that turkey of yours but us. What, you bump into a door or something?
Yeah, a door with a gun.
Huh. You don't need that big old house. Look, I got 40 grand right now.
Oh, that won't buy you a privy these days.
Take at least another 40 to fix it. You ought to donate the place. If you had any civic responsibility, that's what you'd do.
Oh, yeah.
Now, these one big hunk of cheese, you know? So I said, what are you going to do to me? Bash my face?
They're making art out of junk. Junkie art.
I did the best thing a man could do. I ran.
They ran fast, right?
Mr. Hahn,
I think I like this woman.
Well, good. I'm glad you're getting in the spirit of things.
Well, that's one hell of a lady right there. If you turn your head, Mike.
What difference would it make?
It's a statue of you, Mr. Hahn.
It's whoever you want it to be, Claudel.
I think I want it to be you.
Then please get your hands. I have to let them make it a woman.
At least they're awake.
You really know this man, Elias?
Yeah.
Think it's safe to ask him home for dinner?
Safer than it used to be.
Hey, Leroy, you wear the goggles or I'll have you back painting flowers.
Oh, look at Amy's sweet.
Get a minute to myself.
Yes? Margaret, what were you doing?
Michael, what do you want?
Is there anything in the house you can rustle up for dinner?
I'm gonna be late. I'll grab a bite downtown.
What's the matter, Michael?
Nothing.
Just a lot of work.
Don't you know that being early is worse than being late?
I didn't know how long the bus would take here.
Thank you. You're half drowned. Mm-hmm. You waited for a bus in this rain? What are we going to do with your clothes? It'll take hours to dry.
Have you got a robe?
Yeah, in the bathroom, just down here to the left. Don't you have a car?
Yeah, somebody stole it.
No, when?
6 years ago.
Take your time. I gotta finish getting dressed. Pretend you're not here. When I asked you to have dinner, I meant we'd eat it together.
You're a handsome woman.
Oh, you say that to all the girls you meet on the bus. You look positively charming yourself.
Oh, do you have any scotch? Elizabeth, as brilliantly logical as I am, I cannot for the life of me figure out why you asked me to dinner.
I think we talk easily.
We talk easily?
Well, all right. I may not like everything you say, but I think I need it. You're tactless as hell, but you're truthful with me.
So it isn't my body.
How'd you get that thing over your eye?
I was mugged. Isn't everybody?
Was it one of your readers?
No. Felicity's fans are timid, well-meaning, misguided folk. But they're not all dull. Just yesterday, I got a letter from a blind farmer with a seeing eye pig. It's the God's truth. He wants to start a society.
Hello?
Liz!
Oh, God! What are you doing here?
Liz, I need to talk to you.
There's somebody here with me.
Oh, Christ!
No, no, it's okay. You don't know him.
I should never have come.
Oh, thank you.
Him?
Honey, I'll explain.
What's the problem here?
Michael, could you excuse us for just a minute?
Let me guess. It's your transvestite father.
Oh, Paul, don't get excited. He's just a friend.
What's he doing in your robe?
His clothes were drenched. He would have caught pneumonia.
I'm sorry.
Paul!
Call you tomorrow.
He's a 65-year-old man.
He is?
Wait. Michael? Do you think that you... Paul, I'll tell you. Why don't you just...
God. Oh my God. Could you
This is going to be funny someday.
I lost my corkscrew. I didn't lose the corkscrew. I left it at the room.
Ah, yes. The love nest, of course.
Oh, God.
Yeah, thank you. What's so damn funny here?
I love your shorts.
Well, they're new.
Really? Just for me?
No, just for me. Everything else is worn out. Margaret always thinks I'm having an affair whenever I buy new underwear, so I don't very often.
You're smart.
You're gonna get a little roughage with this. Here you go.
He's an undertaker.
What?
Paul is an undertaker. I know. But I've learned a person has to be very special to do that job well.
Don't apologize.
I'm not. Paul's father handled my husband's funeral 11 years ago. Paul did my mother's 18 months ago this week. But he turned out to be more compassionate and understanding than anybody in my family.
So there was a husband. What happened to him?
We were painters. He was working part-time as a welder. One night on his way home, he fell asleep and drove his car into a tree.
Oh, poor kid.
I didn't think I'd get through those first couple of years. But I did. Threw away my Kleenex, started wearing eyeliner again, and I moved to New York.
New York? What did you do there?
Oh, God, well... I worked a couple of auto shows. Hi, this is your high-powered Oldsmobile 442, four-barrel carb, four on the floor, and dual exhaust. I was a receptionist for a dermatologist. You want some?
No, thanks.
Ah, and for 4 years, I painted flesh.
You painted what?
Tones, flesh tones. I was a colorist for a fashion catalog, but they'd only let me work on flesh. It wasn't so dreary, though. Got to change the tones 4 times a year.
Summer, spring, fall.
Summer tan was my favorite.
Well, how'd you find your way back here?
Well, my mother was dying, and I came back to take care of her, and then I found some time to get my teaching certificate.
No men?
That's another dinner. But no, not really. Not till Paul.
Paul? The solid American family type.
He is the family type. He's a very caring and unselfish person.
Who cheats on his wife.
Can't you do this a little more gently?
Isn't it why you asked me here?
Well, I've changed my mind. Let's just get drunk. How'd you end your affair?
Oh, simple. I got caught.
Yeah, but you didn't just turn off your feelings.
The feelings are irrelevant. Elizabeth, romance is cotton candy. Real love is what you do for each other. My friend and I quit communicating and we simply fell out of love. I went back to Margaret with my tail between my legs, and I've hardly even told a lie since.
Michael, I'm not a kid anymore. You had someone to return to.
You're practically an infant.
I'm so particular. Believe me, I've met men. I'll never find someone like Paul.
You'll find one better. Anyway, why do you expect to find the secrets of life in somebody else?
You're a real pain in the ass, Michael.
Carl.
is driving me crazy. Hey, what's happening with him? Man's got a lot of balls,
man. What's it do? You gotta smoke?
Nah, man, I quit smoking.
Yeah.
There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. He shaved them off, but they grew back in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again.
Love is as brief as a flower, but there are few stronger forces on earth. It makes reckless fools out of responsible people, and there's no protection. Even age doesn't insulate us. Only with patience and time do we regain sanity and a sense of proportion. Do nothing rash with your marriage till your eyes have cleared. Felicity. Hello, Elizabeth.
Do you have a minute?
Of course.
Paul explained why he showed up last night.
Well?
He wanted to tell me that his wife is pregnant.
Oh, the old two-time.
Damn it, Michael, that's not what I need to hear.
Well, are you through with him?
He just phoned. I'm going to see him this afternoon.
You're seeing him?
Yes.
One for the road.
Doesn't want our cars seen together. I have to go, Michael. I have another class.
Well, what time? What time? He doesn't want their cars seen together. Huh. The man's a comedian. Does the bus pass by here?
Every 20 minutes, honey.
That's muggy. Can I wait in your lobby?
The bus is 4:50.
And then she says to me out of the blue, I'm 3 months pregnant. How do you like that, Charlie? I don't know how it happened.
You don't know how it happened?
You see how complicated this makes things? I can't just leave her now, can I?
No, you certainly can't. Why didn't you leave her a long time ago?
I've got 3 kids. Now I've got 4 kids. Not that I mind kids. I like kids.
Well, that's good. You got it all, haven't you, Paul? Emily and her litter up front and a good old available Liz on the side.
Listen, I've busted my guts trying to fit you into my life without spoiling everybody else.
And a fine little job you've done, too. It isn't fair. Damn it, it shouldn't have happened, Paul. It just should not have happened.
I know. It shouldn't have happened. Just don't you go and leave me. That's the one thing I couldn't handle. Look what this does to our plans.
What plans? Was there a plan?
You're not going to leave me, are you? We're never going to find anything like this again.
I think I have to. Think about it.
Sexually, I mean. No matter what the books say, I think it's hogwash. I've never been hotter to trot than I am right now.
Oh, good for you, Christian.
What Christian really wants is the exact date you became aware you were losing it.
Oh? What? Well, I'll let you know.
Really?
Who do you think I'm going to
play? Come on, really?
Oh, please don't do that, Margaret.
Michael, I want to talk to you.
I'm going out for some fish and chips. Does that sound all right to you?
You're not going out for fish and chips. You're going out for her.
For who, Margaret? Going out for who?
I can feel something, Michael.
Well, you're wrong, Margaret. You're all wrong, damn it.
Oh.
Dear Felicity, I was horrible on the bus Friday.
Well, well.
I've decided not to see Paul for 3 weeks.
3 weeks? What the hell good are 3 weeks?
I wish I had your courage to quit cold turkey, but I can't do it that way. He doesn't want to stop at all.
Of course the bastard doesn't.
I miss you. Seems like a long time since anyone's kicked my tail. Sincerely,
mired in romantic love.
Going to a funeral?
I guess that's up to you.
I don't know what the hell happened, but Felicity Hope got 35 new letters today.
I'm letting Margaret write it.
This sudden enthusiasm from Felicity has got me puzzled, but I won't question it. You got yourself a couple of months more, friend. Just don't get too sappy with it. I mean, I'd rather throw up my hands in outrage than just simply throw up. Come in my office a minute.
What's on your mind, Jack?
I have an idea for a series of articles on retired men and women. There's no one more qualified to do it than you, you old goat.
Well, hell, I'll take it.
Figured you would. One more thing. From the boys in the city room, a token of their esteem. You look great in drag.
Tell the boys they've outdone themselves.
I want the money. I want the moolah, 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 moolah. I want the money. I want the money. Ha, ha. I want the money, 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 moolah. You want the
suffered a stroke. It may have been caused by the shock of discovering whoever broke in, but we have no way of determining that.
A stroke?
Yes. She's paralyzed and she's very weak.
Is she gonna die?
Chances are she won't pull through. Of course, it's a matter of time before we know for sure, but it doesn't look very good, I'm afraid.
This isn't the way I wanted it.
No, of course not.
Can I see her?
It's late. Go home and sleep. You can see her tomorrow.
Felicity's on vacation for a couple of weeks. The announcement will run tomorrow.
You're a good friend, Jack.
Take the time you need. We'll delay the new feature till next month.
I'll be back in a few days. I have some things to do.
First thing you ought to do is get the hell out of here. You don't need this anymore.
I don't suppose I do.
She is not going to get up, Mike. My mother went the same way. She held on for 6 months, though.
Thanks for the flowers, Jack. Margaret will enjoy them.
Yeah. Well, I gotta be gone. I'll let you know if there are any leads. There's only a couple of hundred unsolved B&Es in this part of town.
Okay. All right, Margaret. A little more suction. That's it. That's it. Right? Margaret? This is a hell of a fix, isn't it?
Your office, they told me about her stroke. Is she any better? You don't look so good.
Oh, I need a shave.
And about a week of sleep.
It doesn't come easy.
Oh.
Welcome to my house. Or rather to Margaret's house. I didn't have a lot to do with the decorating. Well, you're the artist. What do you think?
When did it get like this?
After Patrick. Everything began after Patrick. I guess she figured she wasn't going to lose anything else.
Your son?
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
He drowned.
Oh. You never told me.
It was Tim. It's funny. She had him late, in her 40s. She's older than I am by almost 10 years. But she was in great shape. A dancing teacher. Patrick was such a blessing for her. When she caught me with another woman, he was the one thing that kept her going. And when he was taken away, everything went to hell.
What'll you do with all this?
Get rid of it. Eventually. Right now, I don't have the strength to put a match to the place, let alone get it ready to sell.
Would you let me help you?
Why? So I can continue as Father Confessor?
No, because you've been good to me. And I won't bore you with my unrequited love life. Thanks to you, I think I've begun to transcend it.
I'm happy at least one of us listened.
You know what? You and I could organize all of this together.
I'll manage.
Look at me. How will you manage? Have you eaten? You can't do this.
I can't do anything. I try. I can't.
Well, you're going to do something. You're going to get up and get your things together. You're coming home with me. Come on. I don't have any shaving cream. Michael, did you bring it?
Mm-hmm.
Like Mexican food?
Oh, yeah.
Will you just take your time? It'll be ready when you are. Don't get so excited.
It's very nice. I'm not sure I can eat it all.
Well, just do what you can. You won't hurt my feelings. You want some scotch?
No.
Michael, I know what you're feeling.
Feeling?
Well, Michael Finnegan, just what do I do with you now? Claire, one more meal like this, I'm liable to be sick
again. This is the best you've eaten since you've been here.
How's she doing over there?
Fine, she's on dessert now. She's breaking her own record.
Well, I know she liked that Jell-O.
One more.
Did you remember to bring the candy for the nurses?
Had to come here to finally get some good food.
For the nurses. They said a couple more days. I don't know if I'm waiting a couple more days. You don't look like the same man I brought home a week ago, you know that?
I can go back there now and face it, thank you very much.
Why don't you stay a few more days? It's no trouble. I mean, you don't want to go back to that house till we have it in shape.
Oh, you don't know what you're getting into. Besides, I can't sell anything till she's gone.
All right, then we'll just organize it. Michael, I need to keep occupied.
Well, I'll stay another day, maybe two. No more. Oh, by the way, what's his name called?
Paul?
Yeah, whatever. I told him he still had 2 weeks to go.
Wait. Hello? Paul. Yes, I know he told me, but you promised you wouldn't do this. I miss you too. Yeah, all the time. But Paul, please keep our agreement. Come on, you know better than that. I'm only helping him out.
Better get out.
Don't you dare.
You want to change your mind?
Nope. Just take me on a tour. Oh, my God.
My former sanctuary.
Who would do this?
Mm-hmm. It's an imperfect world.
Eisenhower? Eleanor Roosevelt? Harry Truman? You're a famous man.
Ah, don't let all that stuff fool you. Harry never kept a copy on his wall.
You won a Pulitzer?
Well, there were three of us on the story. It's pure luck.
I had no idea.
You'd be shocked how little it means to me anymore.
Ah.
Hmm? Oh, you've met Felicity.
Yeah. You slept in here?
Mm-hmm. Margaret's room's down the hall.
Seems such an unhappy house for you, Michael. Whatever happened to the woman you were involved with?
Buried last March. She'd grown fat and rich and was a charter member of the Opera Society. We'd lost touch entirely.
I remember that.
Gives the room a certain balance, don't you think?
Well,
I'm... Right.
Can't dance.
You'll dance.
Oh.
Margaret, do you think you're the only dancer in this family? Now, come on, Margaret, I wasn't that funny. Excuse me.
I'm so sorry.
Margaret, it was nothing. Nurse, please.
I'm sorry, please.
Please, honey. It doesn't bother me.
I love you, Michael.
I love you, too. A strange thing has happened.
What?
She's beginning to move her feet.
Margaret is?
The doctor still thinks it's just a matter of days. I don't know what it means.
What else but your good care?
Margaret's more lucid than she's been in 20 years. She suddenly loves me again. She told me.
And you wonder why she's improving?
It's crazy. In a week, it'll be our 35th anniversary. I've felt nothing for her for so damn long. Now it's different. I seem to have wells of compassion I never knew existed in me before.
You know, I sometimes think that what I need in a man won't have developed in anyone younger than 60.
Ah. If only flesh and spirit could grow at the same pace, huh?
Michael?
What?
Could you come down for just a minute?
You keep showing me old books and I'll never get out of that bedroom.
It's not a book. Look, I found it in a book.
Finders keepers?
No, it's worth a look, don't you think?
She wasn't that eccentric. Isn't, I mean.
Michael, $20. You really want to auction these books knowing they could be full of money?
All right, I'll give it a minute. But you realize you were just lucky.
We'll see.
Mm-hmm, we'll see. I'll be damned.
Mom!
All right, let's go through them all.
Oh, wait. There's got to be a system.
Yeah. There was always method to Margaret's madness. She would never put money where she couldn't find it.
Okay, where are the books the money was in?
This is one.
Okay. Pictures from Italy, Dickens, Problems of Art, Langer, Mother, Home, and Heaven, Kyler. What do they all have in common? Come on, you're the detective.
I taught you everything I know.
Ratiocination. They're all black.
Oh, not ingenious enough.
Mm-hmm. It's the obvious clue that's always overlooked.
Huh? Bingo! six and $6,200.
$6,200? I don't believe this.
Hey, it's still early. You have any energy left?
Oh, no.
For a New York strip about that thick?
Oh, boy.
And I know a joint with a dance floor.
Your Honor, I think you lied to me about your age.
Oh, honey, inside I'm 20. Maybe 22.
Ways of going than being danced to death.
How about some eggs? It's nearly breakfast time.
How can I even think about food after the steak I had? Yeah, what the hell, I'd love some. What time is it?
3:20.
I haven't been up this late in years. You have to work tomorrow?
No, I told Jack I'd be back on Monday. There's a bag full of mail for Felicity. And tomorrow, spend the afternoon with Margaret. She likes me to feed her. The nurses aren't patient enough with her.
As you are.
Ah, damn.
You know, I wasn't sure what I was getting myself into when I asked you to stay here. I hate people who think they're always right, especially when they are. But I tell you, Michael, I've never met a kinder man than you are.
Pull your skirt down, will you? You think I can just watch that? I may have settled in here, but I'm not a part of the goddamn furniture.
Well, now, wait a minute. This is my apartment, and I can take off my stockings anytime I want to.
It's just the way you do it. Make me feel like one of your goddamn houseplants.
Well, I certainly didn't mean to.
Hey, Elizabeth.
Hey, what?
Hey, I'm sorry.
Forget.
Let me tell you something. I was never aware of my age until I met you.
Bigger bunch of letters every day. What's wrong with Felicity? She lives in her balls.
If I talk about Patrick, I've been thinking about him all morning. About a time, in August, when he was 7 or 8. It was close to the end of the month. School was just a few days away. He took me by the hand and he said, "I don't want summer to be over, Daddy." He said it like he knew something I didn't. Like how few of them he'd have. So I sang him my song. You know the one.
There was an old man named Michael Finnegan. He grew whiskers on his chin again. He shaved them off, but they grew back in again. Poor old Michael Finnegan, begin again. Patrick, I said, that's just the way it is. Something ends, and we begin again. And again. And again. It's about the only thing we can be sure of. I think he understood. He acted like he did. Was there ever another boy like that?
Hi, Liz. How are you?
Hi.
Is he up there?
Have you gone mad?
Is he up there?
Michael? No, he's at the hospital.
Would you marry me if I asked you? If it had been anybody but that idiot of an assistant minister.
This is like Search for Tomorrow.
My wife has no taste.
Yeah, well, everybody is doing it.
I didn't think Emily was. All those junior league meetings. If you could just see them together. She's a goddamn half foot taller than he is. Abbott and Costello.
You've left her?
Hell yeah, she wants him.
So, Liz gets Paul by default.
Oh no, honey, come here. It's done, Liz. I hate thinking about the kids, but I may just have to go to court for them.
On what grounds? That she's an adulteress? You sure this is what you want?
What does that mean? Of course it is. Hell, I moved into the room.
Into the room? The room. You're gonna move in here. As soon as Michael leaves.
Sure, I gotta go catch up with the bed.
Elias?
Mike, thanks for coming by. Sit down. Man, you sure are clean today. You know, talk has it you're getting your house ready to sell.
I guess that's what I'm doing.
You're not forgetting about us.
My wife's dying, Elias. I guess I better hang on a little while longer.
Well, it's just that I found $5,000 more since last time I saw you. But I don't have time to wait. You know him?
I think I met him once. Who is he?
One of the regulars comes in for methadone.
How old is he?
19.
Is there any hope for him?
He's one of the good ones.
Elias, will you give me 3 months to vacate?
Mike, hey, thanks. That's great. You know, a lot of junkies are going to be indebted to you, man.
A lot of them are already.
Hello? Elizabeth?
Michael, I have to be away a few days. Will you take care of the place? Water the plants on Wednesday. Use the bed. I'll explain when I see you.
What the hell is this?
Thank you.
Brabant's residence.
Hey, is Paul Brabant there, please?
No, he isn't. May I take a message?
I have some business to discuss. When do you expect it? Hello?
Well, he doesn't live here anymore.
Oh?
You might reach him at the funeral home. I'm not sure.
How pathetic this is.
Hi, Howard.
Hello, Paul. Good to see you.
Paul! Paul Brabant! A cocktail party, room 516, tonight!
I'd agree.
Hey, Mort, how's Trix?
Fine! How's things with old Digger Odell?
Paul, don't be shy. You can bring,
meet Liz DeHaan, a very dear friend of mine.
Liz, how are you? Listen, if you don't make the party, I'll know why. I'll see you later.
He has us figured for a convention romance.
It's all right. I'm with you.
Hi.
You know, I'm in love with this woman.
I don't blame you, buddy. I have been for the past 10 minutes.
Maybe I should have worn something more conservative.
Not on your life. Let's get a drink.
Jerry? Oh, I'm glad to see you. Listen, you were at that Ellenville convention, weren't you?
Yeah.
There was a fellow there named Johnson, you remember? Do you remember the name of the company he worked for? Because
I'll tell you what. About introducing a line of economy cabinets.
New for 85. I want to talk Fernwood to Waterfields, top of the line models, brass trim, in sculpted ebony, with tufted quilted satin lining, in a choice of aquamarine, ivory, and new pink. For 75 years, Fernwood has offered the finest in craftsmanship and quality. Our caskets, which are styled in traditional and contemporary patterns, are
Hellman's Aftercare offers a complete line of moderately priced, timeless fashions.
These caskets are suitable for mausoleum interment.
These never-worn garments, crafted in natural fibers,
introduces Greco-Roman caskets in fine imported walnut, teak, and mahogany veneers with carefully crafted bronze ornamental quarterpieces. These top-of-the-line models in sculpted ebony with brass trim.
Hi.
Excuse us. You're not enjoying this, are you?
No. There's a kind of odd fascination.
Come on, let's get out of here.
All right.
You need another drink. This is fantastic. I love it.
You're a terrific dancer.
You're so beautiful, honey. Every bastard in the room is jealous.
No, Paul, no more for me.
I'm not drunk, Liz. I'm just working out a few regressions. Three kids, just like that. It's like I never raised them. Like they were never mine.
Oh, no.
It hurt so much, honey. I didn't know it was going to hurt so much. Maybe I can see them tomorrow. Emily is so goddamn ferocious right now. I wonder if she'll care.
I think she'll understand. Come on, I'll drive us home.
I'm all right to drive if you want me to.
I'll drive.
You want to drive? I can drive.
Thank you.
your ironing.
This is?
Now,
hold your horses. What is this? Whose knee is this? Is this yours? For God's sake, when did this start to happen?
This morning.
It's coming back. Would you look at that? Happy anniversary, Margaret.
Mac, I'm going to leave this place.
Elias Williams, please. Well, when do you expect him? This is an emergency. Well, have him call Michael Finnegan at 545-1236 the minute he gets in. What? Yes, of course it's about the house. Elias? Who? When? Yes, of course. I'll be right there.
She looks good, Mike.
Some of them look like dummies in a store. This Broadbent is a sensitive guy. Where'd you find him?
He's a friend of a friend. Right over there.
You okay, honey?
Jack, meet Elizabeth Dahan. Elizabeth, Jack Archer. She knows a lot about stuff like this. She arranged everything. Even the funeral.
No, I didn't exactly.
She's thinking about marrying into the business. Hello, Helen.
Thanks so much for coming.
You must be the one who helped him with the house.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I am.
It meant a lot to him. He thinks you're pretty special.
He does?
He does. You've been like a daughter to him.
You know, it's not going to look like anything.
What happens if it rains tomorrow?
Tomorrow, if it rains, there'll be a canopy, but today you're not going to see anything.
I just want to see the spot.
It won't be beautiful. The AstroTurf isn't even out yet.
I don't give a good damn about your AstroTurf.
Michael?
I'm fine. I just want to see the grave.
He wants to see the grave.
And we're going to show it to him.
Not very deep.
Standard depth. Careful now.
All right.
This is probably unprofessional, but I need to talk about something. Don't you think it's about time you moved out of Liz's place? I honestly don't think you've got my best interests at heart. In a few days, I'll be moving in there. I'd appreciate your being gone. If I've mistaken your motives, friend, I apologize. Ah! Ah!
him!
He's learning empathy for the customer.
What's going on?
I'd think twice about that man, Elizabeth.
Liz!
He's got formaldehyde on his breath.
He does not! He's a
help me, you son of a...
I'd like him out of my wife's grave. No. Tell him.
Michael Depp, don't you go! How can I get him out of this car? Stay here! Depp. I want to talk to you!
Help me! Help me! Help me!
Paul!
Liz! Get me out of here!
Paul!
That old bastard is paying for a new suit!
Push.
All I did was tell him to get out of your place!
What?
Are you trying to kill me?
What? You picked a time like this to tell him that? You're insensitive, selfish, totally in...
Are you all right? Jeez.
No, I'm not all right! How could you have treated Michael so badly?
Well, when is he going to move out? If he's not going to move out now, when is he going
to
move out?
I don't know, but that's up to me to decide.
You don't want him to leave.
Maybe I don't.
Do you or don't you?
I don't know.
Who the hell do you think I am?
I don't know. Oh, Michael, I thought you were dead.
Felicity's dead. I'm going to Europe.
You're going to Europe? Just without even saying goodbye?
Where's what's his name?
I've ended it with Paul. It's over. Dead. Almost buried.
Congratulations. I hope you use better judgment next time.
Wait, aren't you happy for me?
I'm happy. If you're happy, I'm happy.
Why do I need your approval?
I don't know.
Michael, you come back here. Michael, are you really going to Europe?
You bet. Everything there is older than I am. And what do you care? You're going to go on your merry way and make your next mistake and your next mistake.
Oh, God, you are so self-righteous. Is there anyone you would approve of for me?
Sure. Me.
Why don't you ever say so?
Years from now, it's a toss-up.
10 years. because they're good. Would you trade them for 40 indifferent ones?
This thing is going to roar for about 20 minutes and then go out. Oh, Elizabeth. I only hope.
Just. You for doing my ironing.
Now say that again. For no reason at all.
I love you. For no reason at all.